Today's college football game on ESPNU is presented in high definition.
Welcome to Virginia, and this is Norfolk State University. I'm Joe Cook with ESPNU's Campus Connection. Today, join me, Dwayne Ballin, and Eddie Robinson Jr. for this MEAC matchup between the Hornets of Delaware State and the Spartans of Norfolk State University. MEAC football on ESPNU is next.
The Norfolk State Spartans have a mild winning streak going. Can they continue it here this afternoon at home against Delaware State at Price Stadium? Hi, everyone. Along with my partner, Eddie Robinson Jr., I'm Dwayne Ballin. Welcome to another exciting Saturday from MEAC football. A couple of teams, Eddie, at the beginning of the year, both were picked to contend for the title. Not the case as we stand near the end of the season.
Yeah, things have not gone as planned for Norfolk State or Delaware State for that matter. Of course, Delaware State is a 2007 MEAC champ, so they expected to have some big things going on this year. Norfolk State, they finished third in the conference in 2007. Both of these teams have disappointing years, but you can have some big things happen at the end of the year, and hopefully it can carry on to next year.
You know, it seems that every week it's always the case we have an exciting individual to watch. No different here. Vashawn Winter for Delaware State, quarterback, can do everything.
Yeah, Vashawn Winter has really defined this program under Coach Al Levine. I mean, he has 43 career starts and 23-6 career victories in the MEAC. What I like about him is he does have 7 touchdown passes, but he also has 9 rushing touchdowns, and he leads Delaware State. Dimensional quarterback who can win on the ground and in the air.
And for Norfolk State, they are led by D'Angelo Branch, who is an exciting running back, and if he gets it going, look out.
Yeah, he already has 827 rushing yards. He could go over 1,000 yards today. This guy is a classic inside-out runner, and what I mean by that is he can run in between the tackles, but he's even more dangerous once you let him get to the outside. He can make people miss. He really knows how to finish runs, a determined runner. Already has 9 rushing touchdowns this year.
A couple of exciting offensive performers will be featured here in this one. Hard-hitting MEAC action is on the way. Kickoff, and we return on ESPNU. ESPNU College Football is presented by Citi. Whatever your story is, your Citi card can help you write it, because Citi never sleeps. The beautiful campus of Norfolk State University, a flyover from the military, which has a strong presence here in the Tidewater area. We will talk much more about that as the telecast unfolds. Time to check in first, though, with our E-Rob report, Eddie.
Yeah, I tell you what, this report is getting better every week, and of course we have some good stuff for you once again this week as we focus on Delaware State and Norfolk State. Here it is. I mean, you look at Delaware State, first thing you have to do is protect the football. Norfolk State has plus 13 in turnovers and leads the MEAC. Kareem Jones had 230 yards rushing last week. Whatever he had last week, give it to him again this week, and then pressure the quarterback. If you're Norfolk State, it's senior day. Have that enthusiasm carry over to this football game. Win on third down defensively, and then you have to have some big plays in the passing game if you're Norfolk State with quarterback Dennis Brown.
Norfolk State coming into this one having won 2 straight last week, defeated Morgan State. Delaware State lost 3 in a row. Last week dropped 1-1 to Winston-Salem State. We are underway from Norfolk. Short kickoff. Norfolk State will come out on offense and begin this game. They're led by their quarterback, Dennis Brown, number 10, a transfer from Miami Central High School, a transfer from UConn, where he started at UConn as a freshman. 2 touchdowns rushing last week in that victory over Morgan State. Big fella, 6'3", 205, with a lot of confidence, Eddie.
Yeah, he's definitely the guy who came here from day one and took charge of this offensive football team.
First and 10 from the 33-yard line for Norfolk State. Out of the shotgun is Brown, has a receiver. First play of the game is a pass. The men up front are led by Jamian Banks, who's a preseason first-team all-conference performer. They'll be protecting Brown and his compatriots in the backfield. The backs and receivers are all talented. D'Angelo Branch, we talked about him, but also keep your eye on Jamar Johnson, number 11. Second down, after that seven-yard completion, second and three. Brown to the air again, has another man, has a first down. That's Dario Walker. Defensively for Delaware State today, the men up front, Ron Spinner is the star. He has 38 tackles, does number 94. Linebackers are led by Kevin Connor, who has 76 tackles to lead the team. That is third overall in the MEAC. And the men in the secondary, number 21, Avery Grant is the man to keep your eye on, 61 tackles and a couple of sacks. So it's first down for Norfolk State. Opening moments here at Price Stadium in Norfolk, Virginia. Dennis Brown operating out of the shotgun. First carry of the game for Branch. He's over the right side where he is stopped by Kevin Connor, number 52. And Branch can do this so well. He's one of those momentum running backs, Eddie.
Yeah, this guy really gets better as the game goes on. And what I like about him is he's tough. He can go in between the tackles, but once you let him get out of the box and he gets into the secondary, he can really do damage.
Pick up a five for Branch on that play. Sets up second and five from midfield for Norfolk State. Scoreless in the opening moments here. Opening drive of the game in Norfolk. Brown completes another pass. So far he is perfect. 3 for 3. That one to Jamar Johnson, who came in with 39 receptions, 364 yards, and a trio of touchdowns. Senior from Norfolk, Lake Taylor. Head coach for Delaware State, Al Levan, in his fifth year. 32-22 at Delaware State. Graduate of Colorado State, 1968. He was on George Seifert's 1990 San Francisco 49ers Super Bowl staff. A lot of talent. First and 10. Branch trying to break outside, is tracked down from behind the line of scrimmage. And the first man to get to him was Avery Grant, the strong safety, the sophomore from Brooklyn.
Yeah, Avery Grant, number 21. You can tell, look at the speed he has 61 tackles and 6.5 tackles for loss. So for a free safety, he spends a lot of time in the offensive backfield, spends a lot of time around the line of scrimmage, and a very good tackler, Avery Grant, number 21.
Fourth down situation now for Norfolk State. We will see Billy Rudd, who's averaging 40 yards per punt for the first time, back to receive the punt. Keep your eye on number 22, Brandon Hudson. Fair catch is called, and Delaware State will now come out on offense for the first time in this game. So, Eddie, the Delaware State defense initially passed its first test.
Yeah, they did. I mean, this Norfolk State offense, I mean, they look quite a bit different. Remember when we came here against North Carolina A&T, they were more of an I formation, a physical downhill running game. Now with the emergence of Dennis Brown at the quarterback position, they're starting to be a lot more dink and dunk, running a lot more spread offense. So a bigger challenge for this Delaware State defense, because you have an offense who still has a good running game but can also pass the ball now with Dennis Brown.
So Winton leads the Hornets offensive unit out onto the field from their own 18-yard line. They begin operating. As a man open, complete pass, that's a first down and more. John Hillman on the reception. 20-yard pass play, that's one way to get it going.
That's a big way to get it going. I mean, I thought that thing was picked off. He had number 9, Terrell Whitehead. He had a bead on that thing, the free safety. But Winton, this guy has started 43 games for Al Levan and has been around for seems like forever. And led them to a 2007 MEAC championship, and here, tell 16 touchdowns, 7 passing, and 9 rushing. Very multi-dimensional player, hard to stop defensively.
Hornets now first and 10 from their 38. First carry of the game for Kareem Jones, and he really goes nowhere as he was snuffed out quickly. Josh Turner was there along with his teammates. spot for Delaware State along the offensive line. The name you want to keep your eye on is Adrian Brown, number 77. He's all conference. He anchors the offensive line. Back to the receivers. Kareem Jones is coming off a career-high 230-yard rushing performance that put him over the 1,000-yard mark. Number four, senior from Lansingburg, New York, transfer from Syracuse. Second and 12. There's Jones on a delay, fighting his way up the middle. Three-yard pickup. Defensively for Norfolk State, you look at number one, Dennis Marsh. 46 tackles, one interception. Linebackers are led by number five, Mike Alphonse. 69 tackles. In the secondary, number nine is the man who leads his team in tackles. That's Terrell Whitehead. 74 tackles and four interceptions. He will no doubt have a very active afternoon. Third and nine for Delaware State. Opening offensive drive for the Hornets. To the air goes Winton. Great defensive work.
Corin Harmon. Hammond. Number 34. Only a redshirt freshman. Did a good job of not getting the pass interference. Good tight coverage and reaching across with the right hand. That ball wasn't exactly on target and gave Hammond a chance to make a play. Good deflection by number 34, Corwin Hammond.
So Delaware State will now punt away. Nick Lochner averaging 39 yards per punt. Dario Walker, number 19 and 33. Dwight Fluker-Berry are back to receive the punt for Norfolk State. Lochner gets a high spiral away, and the fair catch is called by Walker just beyond the 20-yard line. That's where Norfolk State will get its second offensive shot of the game here in Norfolk, Virginia. MEAC on ESPNU. We're scoreless with 9:57 remaining in the first quarter in Norfolk, Norfolk State, and Delaware State. MEAC football on ESPNU. Time for today's ESPNU Campus Connection, a program designed to get the pulse of the campus through student-generated content. Today, we're joined by Joe Cook, a senior mass communications major from Portsmouth, Virginia. Joe, welcome to the telecast. We're happy to have you aboard.
All right, thank you for having me.
Listen, we know that in this area, there's a strong military presence, and it seems it's never far from Norfolk State.
Yes, today is Military Appreciation Day, when Norfolk State basically opens its doors to all military personnel. If they come just in a uniform, they get in free. Norfolk State, they recognize all military personnel affiliated with the school as well as those in the community. So it's just a great day.
Quite a treat, Joe. We'll be joined by you throughout the telecast. Welcome, and we'll be talking to you again.
All right. I'll be right here. Thanks.
Okay, folks. Joe is also president of the National Broadcasting Society, and he's a sports editor for the Spartan Echo.
Joe's a busy kid on campus.
He is. His Spartans begin the second offensive drive of the game for them, a completed pass. Covers 7 yards.
It's going to be real important for Delaware State's cornerbacks and linebackers to make good tackles on the edges. You can tell with this spread offense that Norfolk State is running, they do a lot of dink and dunk passes, little 5-yard routes, but they're on the edges. And if you miss tackles, they can lead to very big gains by Norfolk State.
So it's second and three from the 24. Brown rolling to his right, has a receiver beyond the outstretched hands of his teammate. He was looking for Nigel McCowan, the redshirt sophomore receiver. Pete Adrian, now in his fourth year at Norfolk State. He is 56, 60, and 1 overall, 11th year as a head collegiate coach. Last year, he was a MEAC Coach of the Year. Team, as we noted at the top of the telecast, was expected to do a bit better than they are doing right now.
Well, he's beat a lot of teams in the MEAC, has actually beaten every team in the MEAC conference except Delaware State over his 4-year tenure here at Norfolk.
Third and short from the 24. Well, Brown pumped. Maybe he needed to pump again because his intended receiver still hadn't gotten there. He wasn't even close. He was looking for Jeremy Wicker, number 17.
That's the one thing about the spread offense. They don't really have a big yards per catch area, Norfolk State offense. They do a lot of high completion, high percentage completion passes, but they don't really go downtown a lot. So we'll see if they can have a big play in the passing game. You can tell they were trying to go up top just now, but really wasn't on the same page.
Rudd back on to punt away. Ball's fielded by Grant, who has run out of bounds. College basketball on ESPNU continues Sunday when the Rhode Island Rams take on Gerald Henderson and the Duke Blue Devils. After earning a gold medal in Beijing, Mike Krzyzewski looks to lead the Blue Devils back to glory. College basketball on ESPNU Sunday at 4:30 Eastern. Rhode Island Duke is also available on ESPNU High Definition. For more information, log on to ESPNU.com. Look at Vashawn Winston, 1,096 yards for the season. His 5,370 yards overall are number two in Delaware State history. Beginning this drive at the 42, that's Kareem Jones fighting for yardage over the right side. Ran into Josh Turner, number 99, the nose guard. 3-yard run. Jones's numbers, first seven games, but boy, last week was a career for him.
That's what we talked about in the E-Rob report. Whatever he ate last week for the pregame meal, give it to him again, because they really called his number and he responded with a big game against Winston-Salem State.
Second down. We're in Norfolk, Virginia. MEAC football on ESPNU. Norfolk State in green, Delaware State in gray. Jones not too far. Once again, pulling him off is number 99, Josh Turner, the nose guard, who is displaying a nose for the ball today. Just 1 yard on that carry.
In Norfolk State defense, they've always been good against the run throughout Pete Adrian's career, and going to have to do something big in order to have success in the running game against these Spartans. Because one thing they'll do, they'll stack the line of scrimmage and force you to pass the football.
Ball at the 46-yard line of Delaware State. We're scoreless. 7:36 remaining in the first quarter here at Price Stadium. Delaware State on the move against Norfolk State. Winton, time to throw. Overthrew his intended receiver. He was never really open. Was LaRon Moore, number three. Step for step, defender was with him.
And I tell you what, both offenses are just in the sleepwalking mode. You can tell they're just trying to figure out exactly what they're doing defensively here. Trying to go up top, but not really getting any separation from the defender. Quarterback never really had a chance to complete the pass. And we'll see if they can get something going offensively, both teams.
So for the second time, we will see Delaware State's punter, Nick Lochner, who was dead on his average on his first punt of 39 yards. A timeout called on the field. You know, neither one of these teams right now appear to be, and you just alluded to it, in sync. They're not, right now the game plan's not working.
Well, there's no sense of urgency. And what I would have expected from Norfolk State, because you're the home team and it is senior day, you have 20 seniors who are coming out here on the Spartan field for the last time, you would expect them to come out here with a sense of urgency and some enthusiasm, but we just haven't seen that from the Spartans. Of course, we know neither one of these teams can compete for the MEAC crown, but you still have a lot of things that you can play for with two games left in the football season.
Delaware State does lead the series overall, 12-3. They've won the last five, and as we noted, Norfolk State really would like to break out of that. But we are scoreless in Norfolk, Virginia. With 7:24 remaining, Al Levan trying to figure a few things out for his Delaware State Hornets as they have lost their last three games. Standings not where he wanted them to be. As we take a look now, there's Delaware State number six, Norfolk State number seven. Again, they were picked second and third respectively in preseason. But at the top, no surprise, it's what we thought.
Yes, South Carolina State, of course, they're marching along.
Dwight Flokaberry calls for a fair catch at the 10-yard line. That's a 43-yard punt for Nick Lochner. So when we return, Norfolk State's offense will be back on the field.
comprised.
Delaware State, Norfolk State scoreless, 7:16 remaining in the first quarter here in Norfolk. Sunday, ESPNU shoots three college basketball games away from the O'Reilly Auto Parts CBE Classic. First at 2:15 Eastern, the Bradley Braves take on the Florida Gators. Then at 6:30 Eastern, the Lemoyne Dolphins face the city's big boy, Syracuse, led by Johnny Flynn. And at 8:30 Eastern, the UMKC Kangaroos meet the reigning champion, Kansas Jayhawks. The O'Reilly Auto Parts CBE Classic on ESPNU Sunday. For more information, log on to ESPNU.com.
Well, I was about to cheer for the Lemoyne Dolphins at first until you came up with the kangaroo mascot. So I think I'd have to go with the kangaroos in that one.
Look at the Delaware State Band, which has made the trip down from Dover. They'll treat us at halftime with their show. Dennis Brown, number 10, and the Norfolk State offense on the field. No one has been able to score in this game yet. D'Angelo Branch running downfield over the right side. Number three, down by number 52, Kevin Connor, the linebacker, who is third overall in tackles in the MEAC. That's a 7-yard run for Branch.
I'll tell you one thing I am noticing is the field position battle. I mean, each time Norfolk State takes the field, they're further and further, I mean, closer and closer towards their own end zone. So I think just from a field position standpoint, Dell State is making some advances. We'll see if they can make a big play defensively.
Branch with 86 yards and one touchdown in that victory last week over Morgan State. This time it's Takeem Hedgman, the freshman, with the carry. 4-yard pickup. Number 99, Andre Carroll, is there for the stop defensively along with number 20, Mike Gable.
Take a look at Norfolk State, of course, with Pete Adrian going into, well, finishing up his fourth year. I mean, they do have 20 seniors on his football team, but not many of those guys really have significant roles. So this Spartan team will be back intact, of course, led by Dennis Brown, who will be a senior next year, the quarterback.
Branch trying to break outside. Great pursuit by the Delaware State defensive unit. So Brown is unable to crack through. 21 Avery Grant was there, stringing out the play and stopping.
Yeah, defensive coordinator Rayford Perry for the Delaware State. I mean, they do a very good job of playing defense and just keep stringing them out to the sideline. And see that big guy there, that white stripe, he never misses a tackle, and they just push him out of bounds. Good job. Now you have a 2nd and 10 situation for Norfolk State, and that always favors the defense.
You see Connor 52, and there's number 21, Avery. Avery is just for a strong safety. He'll have 61 tackles, a couple of sacks.
And those tackles for loss, too. I mean, he plays around the line of scrimmage a lot.
Brown to the air, has his man, Sharon Childress. That's the tight end, number 40. Defensively, Joe Mendez, number 56, was there. Pickup of 9 yards on the play. So the Norfolk State offense is beginning to move the ball, but the question is, what happens when they get to midfield?
Yeah, that's exactly the question. But one thing with this Norfolk State offense, you have to be careful if you're playing against them defensively, because they dink and dunk. They complete 5-yard passes, 7-yard passes, a run here, a run there. So you start playing more aggressively defensively, and all of a sudden they can take a shot and get the ball over your head if you're not careful.
3rd and 1 for Norfolk State. First down. And a couple of more for Branch. So the chains move for the Spartans.
Number 3.
Spartans
D'Angelo
came into this with 3-4 in the conference, 4-6 overall.
Credit the tackle for number 36, John, and number 52, Kevin Connor.
This is their final home game of the season, senior day. They'll close it out next week down in Winston-Salem. .424 remaining in the opening quarter. Brown out of the shotgun. Branch again into the secondary.
Number 3, D'Angelo Branch, the ball
where
carrier.
He bowls over James Romaine, number 23, who lost his helmet.
Yeah,
Pickup of 6.
I really like Branch. He's just a tough runner. This guy, he's not very big in size, but he has very good speed and the ability to make people miss, but he also finishes runs. You know, he always is falling forward, and you like those type of running backs. He's getting that extra yard or two at the end of every run. A local kid here from Norfolk, Virginia.
Maury High School, as a matter of fact. He's a redshirt sophomore.
had some troubles early on here getting his head together. He's done that and become a very productive member of this team. This time it's Brown, misdirection. He's into the secondary and may get it into the end zone. Not quite. What a pickup. What misdirection. Number 36, Francis Ajayi, finally pushed him out, but not before Brown picked up 50 yards on the play.
Yeah, and Brown put him up and put him down just now. I didn't think the kid was that fast. It seems like everyone had an angle on him, but he just had the speed to outrun the entire Dell State secondary. Here he has the misdirection and goes up in between the tackles, and at that point it's just a foot race, and no one seems to be able to catch Brown until he has a very big game deep into Dell State territory.
And that was a great bit of blocking by 64 Carlton Ford and 76 Jamian Banks. They opened that hole wide open. So the ball is now first and goal at the 10-yard line. Branch, left side. Touchdown saving tackle. By Jackie Watkins, because if Watkins wasn't there, Branch is in the end zone.
Yeah, Branch with the good vision. He recognized the over pursuit of the defense and had the cutback angle, but Jackie Watkins came in and saved the touchdown. See if Dell State can't stop him to and hold him to a field goal here inside the red zone. Second and goal situation for Alavan's defense.
That 3-yard run gets it down to the 7. Delaware State has called a timeout. Defensive coordinator Ray Pettiford and Al Levan want to confer with their defensive unit and see if they can figure out a way to stop Norfolk State from getting into the end zone. Log on to your online source for all things college sports, ESPNU.com. This online service is a gateway to all college sports content from ESPN, combining the latest news with an expanded collection of exclusive material, scores, columns, video and audio highlights, podcasts, live streaming games, and much more. Log on to ESPNU.com today. And now, ESPNU is available in high definition. To get the great action on ESPNU in high definition, contact your local cable operator or satellite provider. ESPNU HD, the big picture in college sports. The big picture for Al Levan is to try and figure out what went wrong on the way to an upper division finish.
Well, I think when you look at having senior quarterback Vashawn Witten coming back for his last year, I mean, you really expected Dell State to compete once again for the MEAC title, but things just really didn't go right for the guys this year. I mean, of course, he's 4-0 against Norfolk State, but had some problems this year. We'll see if they can't get things going again in 2009. But overall, I mean, he really has his program going in the right direction. The first MEAC title in quite some time for the Dell State Hornets last year.
And they clinched that title by beating Pete Adrian's Norfolk State Spartans. Adrian has not won, as you noted, against Delaware State since coming on as head coach here in Norfolk.
Something I know he hopes to change today.
Hedgeman, second man out of the backfield, is nailed. Excellent defensive work by Francis Ajayi, number 36, the cornerback from Silver Spring, Maryland. 1-yard run. So the Spartans inch closer to the end zone, Eddie, but it's getting a little tough, the sledding is.
Well, and I tell you what, after you have that big run by Dennis Brown, you would hate to have to settle for a field goal.
Clouds are beginning to settle in over Price Stadium. The forecast calls for precipitation at some point today. Third and goal from the 7. Scoreless in the first quarter. Brown rolling right. Touchdown! Great reception by Jamar Johnson, number 11. Went up and got it. 6'4", using all of that frame. The haul in, his 4th touchdown of the season.
When you talk about Jamar Johnson, he's more of a possession receiver, but at 6'4", 220 pounds, the redshirt senior is a very big target. And Dennis Brown, look, he's not exactly open. He just puts his hands up and says, I can win the jump ball. And there you see the touchdown by the senior on senior day, number 11, Jamar Johnson.
Extra point is good from Justin Castellat. And Norfolk State leads at 7-0 with 2:06 remaining here in the first quarter at Price Stadium. MEAC football on ESPNU.
We'll be right back. aviation electricians, healthcare technicians, computer technicians. But no matter which path they choose, they all start right here.
I did all my research, and I can get money for college.
If your son or daughter wants to talk about the Army, listen. You made them strong. We'll make them Army strong. To learn more about the Army's 150 different career opportunities, visit GoArmy.com.
Feeling kind of Sunday.
On ESPNU.
Jamar Johnson, the man that just hauled in a seven-yard touchdown reception from his teammate Dennis Brown to put Norfolk State on top 7-0. Scoring drive went 10 plays, 90 yards, and amassed a couple of minutes on the board. Johnson completing it with that 7-yard touchdown reception. So finally, thanks to the big 50-yard run by Dennis Brown, one of the offenses has gotten it going.
You'll see if Dell State can respond. Of course, Vashawn Witten and Kareem Jones off of that big game against Winston-Salem State, they can put points on the board also.
Kickoff is caught by Stephon Hampton. Fair catch. So that's where Delaware State will take over. Their offensive unit, led by the exciting Vashawn Winton, number two, has yet to really get it going. Maybe he can answer now that Dennis Brown in the Norfolk State offensive unit has cracked for 7.
Remember a couple weeks ago when we saw this same Dell State team against South Carolina State, he started off kind of sluggish. Al Levan took him out for a series or two, and then he came back and had a sensational second half. So not saying we're at that point yet, but we'll see if he can't get the Hornets going early in the first quarter.
Beginning this offensive set at their own 37-yard line are their gray and red-clad Hornets. Jones fighting his way across the 40-yard line.
Number 4, Kareem Jones on the carry for Delaware.
Pick up a 4.
I think, you know, we're going to be entering a new age of Delaware State football, a new era, should I say, with Coach Al Levan there next year, because Coach Levan has been there for 55 career coaching games, and Vashawn Witten has been his quarterback for 43 of those games. So now he's going to have to really break in a new quarterback to take this program to the next level. Vashawn Witten has done a whole lot for the Dell State program and Al Levan.
Second and 6. Witten keeps it and slides towards a first down. Terrell Whitehead, number 9, was coming in like a heat-seeking missile.
Yeah, he wisely slid towards the first down. I mean, some things aren't worth it. You still have to finish the ball game. Look at Terrell Whitehead, number 9, right in the middle of your screen. He's loading up the elbow like WWF. I mean,
Eddie Robinson Jr. never did that, though, when he played, right?
Never got caught. That's all that matters. But Whitehead leads this team with 74 total tackles from the free safety position, so that shows you he's very active in the run front for the Spartans.
Pick up of 5. Spartans crowding the line of scrimmage. And Jones may not have gotten that first down. Anthony Cloud, you were speaking of who might be the man to replace Winton. Anthony Cloud, we saw him a couple of weeks ago. He did play a bit. And he will get the baton.
Yeah, I mean, he played pretty good against South Carolina State. Came in there for a series or two and sat Winton so he can see what was going on in the game. But, I mean, here's a guy, you had 43 straight starts with one player at the quarterback position, so now you get your chance. So it'll be a big offseason, a big spring to see if he can step up and make the plays in this offense. Winton does a great job of reading the defense and that spread option attack that they run.
Measurement for the first down. And Jones got enough. Delaware State will move the chains and keep the ball. It also must be good for Glau to be able to have tutelage underneath a guy like Witten.
Yeah, but Sean Witten, a redshirt senior, he seems like he's been at Dell State forever. So it's always good from the quarterback position when you can learn under someone who's doing it underneath the helmet. It's one thing to hear it from the coaches, but when you hear it from a teammate who's right there making those decisions and those tough reads, it really helps you out as a young player.
Don't be surprised, folks, if you see number 8 on the field at the same time as number 2. We saw that a couple of weeks ago. Levan and his offensive coordinator, Doug Sams, will surprise you and deploy that look where Gloud will end up throwing back to Wint on first down.
You telling all the secrets.
I suspect Norfolk State's defensive unit is very occupied at the time.
Okay.
They're not overly concerned with what we're saying. That is the end of the first quarter here in Norfolk, Virginia. Rashawn Wint and the Delaware State Hornets are on the move. They trail it 7-0. Norfolk State leading Delaware State 7-0 as we are set to begin the second quarter here at Price Stadium in Norfolk. Look at the SBN Black College top 10. Tuskegee remains unbeaten as Willie Slater Jr.'s juggernaut rolls on. MEAC lead of South Carolina State, number 2. Grambling from the SWAC, number 3. Anyone there surprise you, Eddie?
Well, Purview may be the team, and they had a very good year last year, but now the Panthers are sitting at 8-1, and they still have a chance to make it into the SWAC championship game if they continue to win, and Grambling should slip up and lose a football game. The Tuskegee Tigers, of course, we saw them a couple of times this year already. They're 9-0 and rolling along, and they're a very good football team.
You see Florida A&M, they're sitting at number 9, one of the most exciting return men in Leroy Vann in the country there. And the Rattlers made a bit of ESPN news and history today. We'll tell you a little more about that later on. First play of the second quarter, 2nd and 6, went into the air. It's picked off. Dwight Fluker Berry, number 33. Transfer from West Virginia, the redshirt sophomore, comes up with the pick.
I mean, this Norfolk State defense has forced 15 turnovers in the last 3 games. They had 7 last week against Winston-Salem State, but this one is an easy one for number 33, Fluker Berry. Throwing it up into double coverage, and he just does a great job of catching the football and staying in bounds. And now the Spartans are in business once again.
So Dennis Brown, thanks to the work of that man, number 33, Dwight Fluker Berry, has the opportunity to get more with the offensive unit. They take over at the 33-yard line. Hakeem Hedgman on the carry, pickup of 3.
Now the weather may be a factor at some point, Dwayne, as you mentioned. I mean, the storm clouds are definitely rolling in, so points may be at a premium in the first half. If Norfolk State can get a good successful drive, get a 10 or 14 point lead, I'll tell you what, it may be tough coming back in the rainstorm here in the 3rd and 4th quarter.
Some very ominous looking clouds on the immediate horizon, moving in fast over Price Stadium. Brown looking to throw. Well, he was trying to connect with Nigel McCowan, number 86, but the ball was overthrown. McCowan really never had a chance to catch it.
And you can see, I mean, of course, they like to run the dink and dunk passes here. They take a shot upstairs for Norfolk State, but I tell you, with the weather coming and, of course, Pete Adrian, a good defensive coach, you have to establish a good running game in this type of environment if it should start raining.
It has just started coming down. The crowds are
on cue.
Folks, umbrellas are coming out. People are running for cover. Completion to Dario Walker, number 19. 6-yard pickup. And the rain is coming.
Yeah, so Norfolk State, I mean, you take a look at D'Angelo Branch and what they can do in the running game. Even though they run a spread offense, he's a very good runner, has over 800 yards rushing this year. Like, that would favor the Spartans because they have an established running game.
Wow, the Eddie Robinson cheering section is here despite the weather. Bring out the umbrellas.
They're diehards. All 2 of them.
Rudd's punt is away. Hudson fields it, bobbles it, gathers it in, still on his feet, cutting back against the grain, finally goes down just over the 20-yard line, a 44-yard punt, and that's where Delaware State will take over. The weather is playing a part in this game. We'll return to Norfolk after this.
The ab coaster system really is getting men and women incredible abs faster than they ever thought possible. The ab coaster is the revolutionary fitness product that is changing the way and the direction you'll work your abs. Only the ab coaster has the revolutionary biometric design that lets you coast your way to incredible abs. The secret is the ab coaster's natural arc motion. This smooth bottom-up motion creates a constant core contraction. From the moment your knees move forward, the ab coaster engages your entire abdominal muscle and keeps it working from start to finish. And with a quick adjustment of the knee pad, the ab...
We're back at Price Stadium in Norfolk, Virginia, where Norfolk State leads Delaware State 7-0, 13-13 remaining in the second quarter. A sliding rain is now falling upon Price Stadium. Let's bring Joe Cook back in, our campus connection, who is a senior mass communications major. And behold, the green and gold. He's down with the band, and this weather is not going to be good for them, is it, Joe?
All right. I'm here with the band. There's a chant that unifies all current students and alumni at Norfolk State University. It's called Behold the Green and Gold. It doesn't matter where you are in the airport, at a conference. When you say behold the green and gold, they will return it. So right now, I'm going to say behold. And there it is right there.
Well, Joe, they are troopers. You need to get yourself dry, my friend. Joe's getting quite the indoctrination into broadcasting.
You know, we talked before the game. I was like, hey, Joe, it's a sunny day. Good thing it's not raining like it was on Friday. Well, I think we both spoke too soon.
Well, it's almost monsoon-like right now. A hard driving rain is coming in at an angle. Delaware State with the ball, trailing 7-0.
I think one thing you have to look at is not just the rain, but it's also the wind. So if you want to attempt passes, I mean, now is the time for Dell State to put it up because the wind is at their back. Because going in another direction, you're going right into the face of a very stiff wind and a rainstorm.
2-yard run. It is now 2nd and 6 at the 23-yard line for Delaware State. One thing, the cloud is moving rapidly across the stadium. We can see the sun on the horizon, so this may be short-lived, this particular deluge. We don't know what's coming later. Delaware State keeps it on the ground. That's Kareem Jones, the ball carrier.
Of course, Kareem Jones, number 4, he had 35 rushes for 230 yards, both career highs for him last week against Winston-Salem State. So they may need that type of effort today. They may really have to get on the back of Kareem Jones and let him pound the football and try to have some success and establish a running game with some bad weather conditions.
After that 3-yard run, it is now 3rd and 5 from the 26-yard line of Delaware State with the rain coming down. Delay, that's a first down as Jones barrels his way up past the first down marker. He is drugged down by number 51, A.J. Harris, the redshirt senior from Hampton.
Yeah, I really like the call. I mean, look at the weather. It's terrible out here, so you just run a little slight delay draw, and the center, number 68, Nick Richmond, gets the block on the middle linebacker, and Kareem Jones is able to do the rest and convert on a third down situation. Now you get a new set of chains if you're Dell State.
10-yard pickup for Jones. They stay with Jones again, fighting his way to the 40-yard line. Pick up a 4. At the bottom of that pile is number 1, the big defensive tackle, Dennis Marsh, number 65, 300-pound transfer from Maryland. Greensboro, North Carolina.
I wouldn't be surprised if Dell State at some point takes a shot deep. I mean, Bashawn Winton, pretty good passer. I mean, he's had some success throwing the football throughout his career, and this is the type of game where you run the football, and all of a sudden you pull it out with a little play action and you try to get a shot over the top on his defense.
2nd and 6. Winton going through the air, in and out of the hands of his receiver. Slippery pass, slippery ball. That was John Newman, number 16. And that's just a byproduct of the rain, which actually is moving on now, and clear skies are coming.
Yeah, that's a good thing. I mean, you always want to have a good weather condition game, but yeah, that ball there was definitely affected because of the weather. Slick football makes it harder to catch. Pass had a little mustard on it coming from Winton. And number 16, John Newman, couldn't hang on. So we'll see how this day progresses, as the weather is definitely going to have an effect.
Third and six from the 40.
Bringing a blitz.
Here comes a blitz. Winton gets away the first time, gets it off, connects with Newman.
Fumble,
and is picked up by Don Carey, number 27. He's going the other way. Touchdown, Norfolk State. An interesting turn of events on one play.
Touchdown, Norfolk State.
That was just a great defensive effort by number 27, Don Carey. This guy just hustled on that play from beginning to end, and he's rewarded with the touchdown. And last week against Morgan State, he had a 94-yard interception return for a touchdown, so he's back-to-back. That's him right there. Well, that's actually number 21, Josh Anderson, who's missing the sack. Don Carey misses the first tackle, but then he comes back and picks up the football and is able to score on the fumble return to give the Spartans a 13-0 lead, and did a great hesitation job at the end. Of course, number two, Vashawn Witten, he's not skilled at making tackles.
And you see number 31, Anthony Taylor, is the man that dislodges the ball.
Yeah, great job there causing the fumble. The linebackers are running. This team has been playing great defense the last couple weeks. 15 turnovers in the last couple weeks, 7 last week, and now you get another one with a return for a touchdown. Last week, the defense scored 2 touchdowns. So, man, the defense is playing great down the stretch for Pete Adrian.
And this one covered 51 yards. There are markers down. And the point after is Riley.
Disregard the flag. The play was not ready for play.
Officials led by referee Clement Williams, Warren Klugman, Jerry Taylor.
Don Carey, he's all smiles. I mean, he's just, last week you get a 94-yard interception return for a touchdown, and now you get a fumble for a touchdown. Great 2 weeks for him.
Extra point is good. So Norfolk State now leads 14-0, 10-16 remaining in the second quarter. The skies have cleared, and the Spartans are marching. MEAC on ESPNU.
Come!
Norfolk State leading Delaware State 14-0 at Dick Rice Stadium here in Norfolk, Virginia. College basketball on ESPNU continues Sunday when the Rhode Island Rams take on Gerald Henderson and the Duke Blue Devils. After earning a gold medal in Beijing, Mike Krzyzewski looks to lead the Blue Devils back to glory. College basketball on ESPNU Sunday at 4:30 Eastern. Rhode Island Duke is also available at ESPNU High Definition. For more information, log on to ESPNU.com. Basketball season is here, Eddie Robinson Jr. I know you're a big basketball fan.
Yeah, you know what? I actually follow the NBA game a little bit more than college. I know you like the college game, especially because you live in that area around North Carolina, Duke, and NC State, and that's a great area of the country to watch college basketball.
It is, and I'm looking forward. I'm actually be working the game tomorrow, the Duke game, with Bucky Waters, and we're looking forward to getting the college basketball season started. See Don Carey, who just had that 51-yard score. Short punt kickoff. It is fielded by Delaware State. Norfolk State trying to catch them sleeping.
Yeah, they did catch them sleeping, because I don't think Dell State was really prepared for that. Norfolk State had a chance to recover that football because the ball was on the ground. Here's a pooch kick to the front line.
Justin Castellot, number 47, the kicker for Norfolk State. But the other side of that is, if you do not complete the surprise and get the ball, you give your opponent field position starting at your 45-yard line.
Yeah, that's the downside. But I think when you're making the coaching call, you always, of course, look at the good side, the upside. But that defense for Norfolk State is playing pretty good today. So I think it was a good call, good try by Pete Adrian.
Reed Jones. Check that. That was actually number 6, Chris Strother, who's coming to the game, a 5'10", 185-pound redshirt senior from Miami, transfer from Central Florida. 7-yard run for Strother.
I'll tell you what, if you're Pete Adrian in Norfolk State, you have to say, we're going to take away Kareem Jones. This guy had 35 rushing attempts last week. We're going to make Vashawn Witten beat us in the passing game.
I gave Chris 7. That was a 1-yard pickup. This time Witten.
Stop and go.
Looking long, but step for step defensively, for Norfolk State was number 18, Jamie Short. He was looking for LaRon Moore, the intended receiver. There is a marker down.
15 yards from the previous spot, the foul requires an automatic first down.
So roughing the passer is called on Norfolk State. That's an automatic first down just when the defense for the Spartans was playing so well, as you noted.
Yeah, and that's a big break for Dell State, because if you don't get that penalty, you're facing a third and nine situation. That always favors a good, talented defense like Norfolk State. But now Dell State has a second chance. I mean, you're at the 29-yard line with a new set of downs. We'll see if they can't make something happen, taking advantage of the mistake by the Spartans.
Number 58, Hassan Craig, a sophomore from Rocky Mountain, Virginia, was the offending Spartan. So Delaware State at the 30-yard line of Norfolk State. First and 10. Winton, time to throw. Rolling to his right. Connects with his receiver. That's Eric Jones, hauled in the pass. That's another first down for Delaware State.
Yeah, Eric Jones plays this H-back position. Only has 9 receptions on the year, but 3 of them for touchdowns. So he knows how to get into the end zone. Just running the crossing route and is able to get a step on number 9, Terrell Whitehead for Norfolk State. And moves those chains. They get another big first down for Vashawn Winton in Dell State.
Ball now at the 13-yard line for Delaware State. The Hornets' deepest penetration into Norfolk territory so far in this game. Chris Strolder goes nowhere. First, he was met kind of like a ping pong ball, bounced off of number 59, Joey Christen.
Dwayne, we'll have to take a look and see. Maybe Vashawn Winton will start calling his own number a little bit more, because when he has this read option in his spread offense, sometimes he takes it from the running back and he'll take off and run himself. I mean, he has 434 rushing yards and also leads the team with 9 rushing touchdowns. So now in the red zone, this may be an area where he wants to exert his dominance in the run game.
1 yard run on that, 1 yard pickup on that run. Now 2nd and 9. Norfolk State leading it 14-0, 8:27 remaining in the second quarter. Winton, just like Eddie Robinson Jr. suggested, calls his own number, still on his feet, pulling his way into the end zone. Touchdown, Vashawn Winton. Thank you, Coach Eddie Robinson Jr., offensive coordinator.
Well, it just seemed like the right time for him to run the football. I tell you, that was a great call, because you've been featuring the running back so many times. He has 25, 30 carries last week. And what I like about this is you fake it to the running back, but then the running back turns into the lead blocker. Very well-designed play by Al Levan. And, you know, I'm not going to sit up here and take all the credit. Major, the producer, gave me a tip that said, hey, maybe the quarterback's going to run it in the red zone.
So Major Howe, our producer, and Eddie Robinson Jr., co-offensive coordinators, honorary for that particular play.
Worked out good for Dell State.
It did. Sean Winton now with 8 touchdowns on the season. Point after by Nick Lochner. It's good. And the Hornets are on the board. 14-7. Delaware State trailing. But they are in the game.
Delaware.
This telecast is being broadcast in stunning high definition, available on ESPNU HD, and you see the sun is out. Hard to know that there were monsoon-like conditions just moments ago here in Norfolk, Eddie Robinson.
Well, rain, go away, come back another day. I mean, it works.
There's Vashawn Winton, who also works, the senior quarterback, just reeled off a touchdown run after 5 plays and 45 yards. His 12-yard run puts Delaware State squarely in the game with 8:19 remaining in the second quarter. Short kickoff is fielded by Devontae Reynolds, a redshirt freshman from Warsaw, Virginia. Very little on the return. And Norfolk State's offense now will come back out onto the field, led by number 10, Dennis Brown.
That was a real big drive for Delaware State, because you went down 14-0. You just gave up a touchdown offensively, and They were, of course, aided by that big 15-yard roughing the passer call. And after that, a couple big plays, and then it was capped off by the running touchdown of Ashawn Witten. And, of course, it puts him right back in his ball game, 14-7.
There is another flag on the field. We'll hear from referee Fleming Williams.
We have encroachment on the kicking team. The 5-yard penalty will be added to the end of the run. First down.
So a bit more plus yardage for Norfolk State before the first down snap takes place. Norfolk State has two scores, but only one from this unit.
Yeah, of course, their defense has scored two touchdowns last week. They scored another one today on the fumble return for a touchdown. And offensively, they've only had one score, but they've done a pretty good job of moving the football. Here they come with an empty backfield for Dennis Brown and quarterback.
And Durown really doesn't go anywhere. A host of Delaware State Hornets were there, led by number 95, Tyron Hurst. So there wasn't much fooling anyone at all on that play. They tried to run Takeem Hegeman out of the slot and around, but very alert play by the defensive unit for Delaware State.
Yeah, Delaware State, man, they still have a pretty good team speed on that defense, so they're able to defend those plays on the edges. We'll see here, they come with the same formation, the empty backfield. Maybe they go up in the air this time.
Second and 9 from the 44-yard line. Brown, quick pass. He was looking in the direction of number 86, Nigel McCowan. It was low. Defending on the play was Jerome Strums, number 29. Norfolk State's offense still doesn't appear as though all parts are firing.
Yeah, not at all. I mean, of course, you had the big run by Dennis Brown that put him into scoring position. That's how they were able to get the one score. But just from a series to series, they haven't really had a lot of continuity. And on the year, they're only 29% on third down conversion, which is 8th in the MEAC. So that hasn't been one of their strong parts. And now you're facing a third and long.
Brown delayed a branch. Branch is met well short of the first down.
That's number 3, D'Angelo Branch.
The first man to get to him was number 52, Kevin Connor, the senior linebacker.
That's a good job up front, but that's almost like a Statue of Liberty play. You could tell all of the offensive linemen, they set like it was a pass play, trying to get the defensive line to run upfield. Then you convert to start drive blocking, trying to move them out of the way. Good design on the play, but on the third and long situation, Dell State wasn't fooled at all.
By the way, Connor, number 52, now has 6 tackles in this game for Delaware State. Billy Rudd is on to punt away to Brandon Hudson. Hudson
fake.
And is on 15-yard line. The fake is good. That's a first down and much more for Norfolk State. On the receiving end of the fake was Marquise Cuffey, freshman defensive back from nearby Virginia Beach. Play covered 29 yards and good enough for a surprise first down for the Spartans.
Yeah, great job of throwing the football by the punter, Billy Rudd.
That'll shake things up.
Yeah, definitely. Because, I mean, now you have your offense coming back and they're right at the edge of the red zone at the 23-yard line. And no one's out there. I mean, you have 36 Marquise Cuffey is out there uncovered. And I don't know if that was a design fake or that was just a good recognition by the punter and the wide guy.
I suspect that was designed the way Rudd looked. Rudd was looking in his direction the entire time. When as soon as the ball was snapped, he had it. He was looking in his direction.
Yeah, but that was definitely a mental breakdown by Delaware State because you never leave that wide guy uncovered like that. Now, that was on the Spartan sideline, so I wonder if it was a situation where maybe he just ran across the numbers and then lined up on the edge of the field and never really came into the huddle. It could have been some other type of trickery where Dell State didn't recognize that he was out there and uncovered.
So it's 2nd and 6 now for Norfolk State at the Delaware State 14-yard line. Edgerman and Branch in the backfield along with the quarterback, Dennis Brown. Markers fly on the field. Some movement before the snap by Norfolk State appeared to be the transgression.
Prior to the snap, false start. on the offense. Number 6-6. 5-yard penalty. Second down.
Yeah, and we have a late flag that came in from off the Dell State sideline. I think it may have been an unnecessary roughness call. Personal foul. It was well after the play, so it was the linesman who threw the flag. We'll see what the call is.
Is Pete Adrian a man who stresses accountability and discipline?
We have a dead ball, personal foul on the offense. Number 19, a blow to the head. 15-yard penalty, second down.
That's Dario Walker, the redshirt senior from Ettrick. 5'8", 165 pounds. Who's he picking a fight with?
Yeah, and what happened, he was kind of matched up with one of the cornerbacks for Delaware State, and he just got into a personal thing. And that's a very selfish play because now you set your team back another 15 yards, and you, after that big fake punt, you were at the 20-yard line. So now you're backed up with a second and forever situation, and you're not even in field goal range. You can't have those type of selfish plays if you're on any team, especially, you know, when you're trying to win a football game.
27 to go on second down. Brown, time to throw. Completes his pass across the middle. Receiver still on his feet. That's number 6, P.J. Hayden, the freshman from Fredericksburg. Picks up a big chunk of that 27 back. So it makes third down manageable.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, Dennis Brown here completing the crossing route. Just looking at the receiver, just a good job of getting separation from the defender and good run after catch yard. So like you said, now they're in a situation where they can have a play in their playbook to try to get this thing into another first down situation and get into the red zone.
19-yard play. Hayden getting more action than we saw him earlier in the year when we saw Norfolk. He's quite active today. Brown rolling right. Has his man. That should be good enough for a first down. Completed to Nigel McGowan, number 86. McGowan, a redshirt sophomore from Mechanicsville, Virginia. 6'1", 201 pounds.
Yeah, and Dennis Brown and his offense, they've run this play a couple times today. It's just a rollout, and the receiver, he just pretty much finds his own. And what I like about that, you have an active quarterback like Dennis Brown. You give him a run-pass option. It really threatens the defense on the perimeter.
So that 11-yard pickup has negated the roughing the passer, the unsportsmanlike conduct, rather, penalty. So it's first down. On the ground, Hedgman cannot get away from number 35. Francis Ajayi, number 36, rather, on the tackle. Good defensive work by the junior from Silver Spring, Maryland.
Yeah, I'm really impressed with the cornerbacks for Dell State. They do a good job of just bouncing everything to the outside, and then the corners are really stepping up and making good tackles. That's actually a tackle for loss. So when you have some cornerbacks who can tackle, you can afford to force the running back to keep bouncing it to the outside because you have some cover guys who can still tackle within your defense.
5-yard loss, courtesy of Jai. There goes Brown on the move. Touchdown up the middle.
A quarterback keeper, number 10, Dennis Brown.
Once again, his feet are the catalyst for 7 points.
And that seems to be the scoring formula for both of these teams. Once you get into the red zone, you let the quarterback take control and let him be that extra player that the defense can't account for. And that running back goes in there and leaves that lead block, and then your quarterbacks are running in and scoring touchdowns.
16-yard run for Dennis Brown, the junior from Miami by way of UConn.
Yeah, good blocking up front. It just looked like the linebackers for Dell State over pursued. And that left a hole in the interior of the defense.
Extra point is up and good from Justin Kestelot. So Norfolk State now in control, 21-7, 3:09 remaining in the second quarter. FAMU's band making a bit of history on ESPN. More on that when we return. MEAC on ESPNU.
Expedia.
Norfolk. Norfolk State leading Delaware State 21-7 in the second quarter, 3:09 remaining before halftime. History made today on ESPN's family of networks as College Game Day found its way to Tallahassee, Florida, not Florida State, but Florida A&M, the first time College Game Day was presented from an HBCU, Hampton and Florida A&M taking on each other. Today, of course, Joe Taylor facing his old team, Chris Fowler, Mr. Herb Street, coach, everyone there for College Game Day, and the band, Florida A&M, really treated our colleagues to quite a show.
Yeah, I mean, that Rattler band can definitely steal a show. They're the Marching 100, but it's probably around 450 of them, and they are very, very exciting. It was just a great atmosphere to have College Game Day on the HBCU campus. It's just a great job for the MEAC and great exposure for all of the universities.
Low kickoff. Not much of a return. That's where Delaware State will turn over. There are some extracurricular activities, pushing and shoving going on down on the field. The officials come in. Referee Williams and his crew do a good job of separating the players. No flags, just reminding everyone, rules of engagement are this, gentlemen.
Yeah, you have to have a good, strong referee in those situations. Of course, this is a college football game, so you know, these guys have a lot of emotions going back and forth, and yeah, you hit me a little too hard and you hit me late and shouldn't have hit my teammate and all those type of things. So you have to have referees who can come in there and clear things up quickly.
So Vashawn Winton and his Delaware State Hornets teammates are looking up the mountain, trailing 21-7, 3:03 remaining. They begin with a muffed snap. I'm sure that hope that does not portend for a tough series. That's Kareem Jones, number four, gathering in the loose ball and carrying it 2 yards to the 36-yard line of Delaware State. But this offense really has to get going, because if Norfolk State's offense has figured it out, look out on senior day here in Norfolk.
Yeah, I mean, Dennis Brown has made all the right calls. Of course, he had two big running plays, a lot of short completions, but he's been effective on third down. So the Norfolk State offense is really hitting the stride, and it'll be up to Dell State and, of course, talented quarterback Vashawn Winton to respond.
Second and eight, Winton looking to throw. Overthrows his receiver, picked off by Don Carey. His second interception of the game. Already has one return, 51 yards for a score. Let me correct that. Carey picked up a fumble and ran it back 51 yards. That's the second interception of the game for Norfolk State. The first one by Dwight Fluker Berry. So the seniors are really enjoying themselves in green and gold today so far.
Yeah, I mean, and Don Carey, of course, he's one of those seniors, so he has to be very excited. You get a fumble return for a touchdown. Now you come back and you get an interception that you have a good return on. And this ball was just thrown too high. It was up in the air, and once it was tipped, it was fair game. And with all of those defensive players around, you knew one of the Spartans would come up with that interception.
Carey had two interceptions last week in that victory over Morgan State. So he is on a roll and sets up the offensive unit nicely as Dennis Brown and his teammates, thanks to the fifth interception of the year for Carey, take over. And there's miscommunication there between Dennis Brown and number 22, Takeem Hegeman, who never turned around. The ball hit him in the back. A marker is down. And that was a clean hit. It can't be for the hit.
Yeah, it may have been for taunting after the hit. We'll have to see
what
ball, the call is.
Personal foul, defenseless hit on a receiver against the defense. 23, 15-yard penalty. First down.
Now that's number 23, James Romaine. You don't think that's a clean hit?
Well, you know what he's calling is a defensive receiver. And I think the kid was defensive. I think that's a good call. Now, I don't think he really called the taunting aspect of that, but what he's saying is that the ball was clearly on the ground. And as the defender, you should have realized that the guy was looking back and the ball had just, you know, landed on the guard ground. There was no need to hit a defensive receiver, and that was the call.
Okay.
You can't just take shots at guys. You have to square them up and hit them within the confines of the ball game.
Well, I'll take that from a defensive player, because that's something you would be mindful of. Brown on the keeper. Now, you defensively, if you're Delaware State, all of a sudden you've got to be really mindful that number 10 is going to take off and run on you. He has a 50-yard run. And a 12-yard touchdown run, so you have to watch him now.
Yeah, because what they're doing is they're running this play where they're pulling the guards, and he's faking it to the running back, but then he's calling his own number, and he's running up in the middle of the defense, and all it is an influence play.
This time it's D'Angelo Branch still fighting his way on his feet. Very near a first down on the far side. Dennis Brown, not a bad day at all.
Yeah, I mean, look at the high completion percentage, 9 of 14 passing, but then the three carries for 72 yards. He's thrown for a touchdown and rushed for one, so that's no interceptions. That's a great day for a quarterback. You take that.
And we are still 1:17 away from halftime. Timeout called by Norfolk State on the field. I guess the offensive coordinator, Kurt Mastromatio, wants to make sure that the players understand what the game plan is going here, because they have the opportunity to really close things out early on if they can get control of this. There's the Florida A&M U band. We talked about them earlier, game day. What a show they put on for the crew.
Man, they always put on the show. I mean, this band has been great for the last 50 years plus. I mean, they look at them. You don't have to talk about that.
Nice and clear down there, too.
Oh, Tallahassee, you always expect a nice, clear day.
Yeah. Well, there's a lot of excitement down at Florida A&M.
I have a buddy of mine. He was a member of the FAMU band back in the 70s. And so I always kid him. I said, man, you guys are still the Marching 100. Your number's around 400 now. Change the name.
Tuba's all shiny, trombone shiny, everything looks good. Yeah. And the sun is shining here in Norfolk State after we flirted with some very rough weather. The Delaware State Hornet Band has made its way down from Dover, and they'll treat us at halftime, along with, of course, the Spartans. Behold the green and gold.
Yeah, so the bands are just a big tradition in HBCU. I mean, of course, you have great bands at Ohio State and Michigan, but in the HBCUs, I think the fans, they really get behind and support the bands almost as much as they support the football teams. They really come for the halftime performance.
What one notices the difference in the HBCU games and the majority school games is that the fans do not get up and go to the stands, go to the concession stands and the restrooms at halftime. They keep their seats and are fixed their gazes on the field.
Yeah, I mean, the band is all part of the entertainment package. I mean, Coach Eddie Robinson, the late great coach of Grambling State.
No relation.
No relation, of course. One thing he always pointed out was that the bands are as part a biggest part of this entertainment package as the football teams.
Second and goal from the 4 for Norfolk State, already leading 21-7. Brown to the air. Touchdown, second one of the game for Jamar Johnson.
Of course, that's the mismatch like that you like to exploit if you're in the red zone. I mean, Jamar Johnson goes 6'4", 220 pounds, another one of those seniors for Pete Adrian, and just throw a pitch and catch. You just go up high, and this is his second one. Both of the passes were high passes where he was able to outjump the defender, and just a great throw by Dennis Brown, giving your receiver a chance to go up and catch the ball inbounds.
Extra point by Justin Castellot is good. So the Spartans add on to their total, now leading at 28-7, 41.9 seconds remaining in the second quarter. Scoring drive was 4 plays, 32 yards, 1 minute and 37 seconds left. How do you not find a guy who's 6'4 and 220? How do you not know where he is?
Well, they knew where he was. You just can't stop him. And that's one of those things where you can have the guy covered. You're in position, but until you make the play on the football, you really don't have him covered. And when you have a guy like Jamar Johnson, I know Jamar just says, hey, just throw it up high, big guy. I'll go and get it. I mean, this guy has been all MEAC receiver last year, and now he's having a very good year at 3 touchdowns coming into this game and 2 more today. So that's 5 touchdowns on the year. He's a big possession type receiver. You like those type of players in the red zone area.
Redshirt senior from nearby Norfolk, Lake Taylor High School.
You talk about it being senior day. You look at the senior class. There's 20 Spartan seniors. With that class, they have won 20 games. They competed last year for that MEAC title, came real close, except for that loss to Dell State. And that's the most wins of a senior class since 1997, when that class had 24 wins. So you have to give credit to those guys for being here. Of course, this is Pete Adrian's 4th year, so this is the first class that he took from freshman all the way to seniors. They've had a very big turnaround here at Norfolk State, and a lot of good things to come because you have a lot of players returning next year from this football team, key contributors.
With Eddie Robinson Jr. and our entire ESPNU crew, I'm Dwayne Ballin. You're watching MEAC football on ESPNU. It's senior day, as Eddie just alluded to, for Norfolk State, wearing green with gold letters, taking on Delaware State wearing gray with red lettering and red helmets. Norfolk State Spartans offensive unit has begun to click. Defense is playing well, and the Spartans with the home crowd are winning 28-7 with 41 seconds remaining before halftime. Once again, a low kickoff. They do not want to risk an easy return. Still on his feet on the far sidelines is number three, LaRon Moore. Moore usually does duty as a receiver, but boy, did he turn on the Jets up the sideline on that return.
Well, sometimes when you try those squib kicks and the ball bounces around the ground as a cover team, you start to relax. You think that, you know, we have them pinned, and all of a sudden you have a guy like LaRon Moore that busts out of there, and now you have a big return, and Dale State is in position to try to put points on the board right before the half.
Well, there are 31 seconds remaining, and number two for Delaware State, Bashawn Winton, is a big play individual. And he could make something happen right away. First down at the 24-yard line of Norfolk State after that 60-yard return by Moore. Went in time to throw, has a man wide open across the middle. Hauls it in, that's a first down. And that's completed to Eddie Brown, the senior from Miami.
And keep in mind, Dale State, they still have a lot of timeouts. This pass was a little high, but a great job by Eddie Brown to bring it in. So, Bashawn Winton can still turn into a runner also. I wouldn't be surprised if you see a quarterback draw or a situation where he tries to run the football because you still have timeouts if he doesn't get it into the end zone.
17-yard pickup leads to first and goal from the seven. Kareem Jones getting the call. 3-yard pickup. So Delaware State now calls timeout. MEAC News and Notes, Kareem Jones. We mentioned that amazing performance he had last week. Brian Packer of Florida A&M, defensively doing well, and Dwayne Clark of South Carolina, the newcomer of the week. Everything's going well for the Bulldogs, though, this year.
Yeah, the Bulldogs, I mean, they are living up to the billing that they had in the preseason. Of course, the last couple years, they were picked to win the conference, and it was always a game here or a game there. But I think this year, Buddy Pugh, I think they will go on to win the MEAC and represent the conference in the playoffs, and hopefully they can get a conference win, one that the MEAC has been desperately seeking for the last couple of years.
More accolades are coming in this telecast as we unveil the E-Rob Report Awards, and anxious to see, partner, just who do you think is the best this year?
Well, you know, we've seen quite a few MEAC games. Of course, the last 3 weeks in a row, we've seen, you know, different MEAC teams play, and a lot of good players, a lot of good talent in this conference, and very competitive conference. I mean, every team has been beaten differently. Even Winston-Salem State, who doesn't compete for the championship now, their games won't count until the next couple years, but they were able to beat Delaware State and win some big games. They beat Hampton a couple weeks ago. So a real competitive conference. All the teams have a chance to win every week.
So what can Mr. Winton, number two, do with 10 seconds remaining in the half? He throws what should have been an interception. That should have been picked off by number 18, Jamie Short. Well, Delaware State calls the timeout. You talked about seniors, and this is a big day for Norfolk State. But here's one of them, Don Carey, who's a senior. He's having a big game. What does it mean as a senior, Eddie, just to really perform on that day?
Well, I think you know that this is your last game ever playing in this stadium, on this stage, and it is special. And you see a guy like Don Carey getting a fumble return for a touchdown, and he comes back with another big interception. I mean, what else can you ask for? That's how you want to end your college football career. Then you come back with Jamar Johnson. I mean, this guy's been around for the last couple years, all MEAC performer last year, and he's a big play receiver. He gets two touchdowns on the day. I mean, that's just really makes you feel good about your college experience. You say you ended it on a winning note in front of your hometown fans.
Let's see if some of those senior defensive players like number one Dennis Marsh can stop Delaware State from getting 6 points. With 6.6 seconds remaining, Hornets at the 4-yard line of Norfolk State in desperate need of a score, trailing 28-7. Winton's pass was nowhere close to being caught. Short once again was there defensively. So that brings up fourth down and goal. Delaware State calls another timeout. Maybe they should go back to your earlier suggestion. Call number two's number. Let him create. He's 4 yards away.
Well, now on a fourth down, when you have an active quarterback like a Vashawn Winton, I always like to see him in a rollout position. That way you can put pressure on the edge of the defense with a run pass option. Now that it's fourth down, I still like that same call. I mean, you roll him out to his right, give him a chance to run or throw the football. This guy is talented enough to make the right decision.
Last week he had 145 yards, 3 touchdowns, the most in a game he's thrown since his sophomore season, if you can believe that.
I mean, this year he just hasn't been on all cylinders. Had a couple of off games, and things just haven't really clicked for this offense throughout the year. But this guy's had a great career at Del State. Now it seems like they're going to settle for the field goal and not go for it on the fourth down.
They are going to bring in Riley Flinkinger, who is 7 of 15 on field goals. 21-yard attempt. From that distance, he is 4 of 5 this season. Norfolk State has decided it wants to make Riley think about it a bit, so they're going to call a timeout and freeze him. You agree with this call? You really need a lot of points. You've got Winton, who, law of averages, he should be able to create from 4 yards out.
Yeah, going, when you say you're on the road, you're down 28-7, is this point in the football season where you only have 2 games left, I would be more inclined to go for it on fourth down and give your kids a chance to compete, and you never know what happens. I mean, you may not get it, but hey, you have to have that type of mentality, like we're going to compete and throw everything we have at the football game.
The MEAC standings, as the day begun, South Carolina State unbeaten in conference play. And remember, those two losses were to Clemson and Central Florida, so they were not easy games at all, and they've pretty much dominated the competition.
Yeah, I think they have a big game against Morgan State today, so for all practical purposes, the Bulldogs should close this thing out and win their first outright MEAC title since 1994. And then Bethune-Cookman, who we saw last week, are sitting there at 4-2 and 7-2 overall. Of course, they have a big matchup at the end of the year again in the Florida Classic against FAMU.
Here's a 21-yard attempt by Flinkinger. It's up and good. So as the half expires, give 3 more to Delaware State. But it's Norfolk State, which leaves the field with a confident, dominant stride, leading 28-10 at home on Senior Day before a crowd at Price Stadium. You're watching MEAC football on ESPNU. We're at the half.
You girls have fun.
Norfolk State leading Delaware State 28-10. Welcome back to Norfolk, Virginia. The sun is shining on Dick Price Stadium after we flirted with rain in the first half. First half highlights for Delaware State, number two.
Yeah, Vashawn Winton, he had some success early. Here you see a big pass completion. But really, Dennis Brown is the quarterback that stole the show. Here you see a 50-yard rushing play after the fake to D'Angelo Branch. And this guy has really been sensational, especially running the football. Here he has another fake. And pretty much they've used Branch as a decoy, and Dennis Brown has been calling his own number with the rushing touchdown. He also has two passing touchdowns to give Norfolk State the big halftime lead.
He has 72 yards rushing on the ground. Those numbers speak well for Norfolk State.
Yeah, but Sean Witten, he just needs to get this thing going. I mean, he had the two interceptions. I think one was a tip, which really wasn't his fault, but no touchdowns and only 62 passing yards. I think Witten really has to get his team going and moving in the right direction. May want to do some more things in the running game from the quarterback position. He came into the game with 9 rushing touchdowns. We expected more of a running game from Rashawn Witten at the quarterback spot.
So Norfolk State kicks it off to begin the second half on Senior Day. Delaware State's offense. We'll get first crack after LaRon Moore returns it down out over the 43-yard line. Moore has had some exciting moments returning kicks in this game for Delaware State. He will remain on the field as one of their wideouts, a sophomore from Hyattsville, Maryland. He's also a member of Delaware State's track team, which is why he flies up the sideline so quickly.
Careful with those track guys. When you see them on the football field, you know if they get a step on you, they definitely have the speed to separate and get the ball into the end zone. And Dell State will need a big start here in the third quarter. They want to get back into this football game.
Thanks to that 33-yard return, Delaware State has the ball at its own 42-yard line to open up the second half, trailing 28-10. Went to the air, and he overshoots his intended receiver, who was Moore. And so far, it has appeared that Winton really hasn't been on the same page with his receivers, with very few exceptions.
Yeah, especially, I mean, this guy's a fifth-year senior. He started 43 games for Coach Al Levan. You would expect that from a quarterback-receiver standpoint, these guys should know each other extremely well, but that just hasn't been the case today. And, you know, sometimes in football, you just have to fight through a sluggish performance and still gut it out and try to get the victory.
Man in the backfield with him is number 4, Kareem Jones. Out of the shotgun, operating is Winton. Jones gets the carry. Right up the middle, still on his feet. He has a first down before he's finally corralled and drugged down.
In this situation in the game with Delaware State, you're down 28-10 at the half. But it's still not a time to panic. You still can have Kareem Jones be a factor in this football game. Have your run pass and your pass plays. If you get a score or two, you're back into the football game. The biggest thing is you don't want to just go into a run and shoot offense and totally abandon the running game when you have two quarters of play left.
That 11-yard run puts Delaware State into Norfolk State territory. Jones again. This time he is tracked down by number 50, Sean Childress, the inside linebacker.
Norfolk State defense, I mean, they're playing with a purpose. I mean, they're coming out in the third quarter like they're down by 18 points instead of playing with a lead. I like the enthusiasm that they have showed over the last couple weeks. This defense has been sensational. 15 turnovers. They have 2 turnovers today. They put another score in the end zone off the fumble recovery for a touchdown in the first half. Defense playing extremely well for Pete Adrian down the stretch.
Looking to throw, has a man open. He had it and lost it. Could not hold on to it. Number 88, Eric Jones, had it.
And he plays the H position in this offense, the slot position, and here is no safety. I mean, he catches this ball. That should be a touchdown. That's one that you have to have. I mean, you have a couple steps on the receiver. You have the separation. Winton throws a perfect pass in both of your hands. You have to have that play. Your team is down by 18 points on the road.
That's 6 points right there. Now, a year ago with McBride, that's automatic.
Oh, yeah, that's a guaranteed 6 points. McBride was that type of receiver. So maybe part of the problem with this passing game.
Looking for a receiver to step up and become the man. And if you look at the numbers.
On the offense, number 2. 5-yard penalty. Third down.
The numbers suggest that Eddie Brown, the senior number 5, is the man to go to. LaRon Moore, number 3, who's been running back those kicks, had a pretty good game last week in that loss to Winston-Salem State. but no receiver really has stepped up to connect with number two and put and become a deadly tandem. Third and 21 from its own 46-yard line is Delaware State. Out of the shotgun is Wendt. Looks like he's going to run, and he is hustled out of bounds, where in quick pursuit of him was number five for Norfolk State, Mike Alphonse, the outstanding linebacker.
Good job by Norfolk State. Of course, they dodged the bullet with the pass that was dropped for the touchdown, but hey, that's part of football. They did a good job there getting off the field on third down. They haven't been particularly well at doing that this year, but today they've been doing a pretty good job of stopping Dell State on third down.
Nick Lochner on to punt. He's standing back at his own 41-yard line. Dwight Flookerberry and Dario Walker set to receive. That will sail into the end zone. So Norfolk State will get the ball at the 20-yard line. College basketball on ESPNU continues Sunday when the Rhode Island Rams take on Gerald Henderson and the Duke Blue Devils. After earning a gold medal in Beijing, Mike Krzyzewski looks to lead the Blue Devils back to glory. College basketball on ESPNU Sunday at 4:30 Eastern. Rhode Island Duke is also available on ESPNU HD. For more information, log on to ESPNU.com. Mike Krzyzewski's Blue Devils once again ranked in the top 10 early season, expected to make a run for the ACC championship. At the very top of that league, of course, is the people that are 8 miles away from them, the North Carolina Tar Heels, who are loaded. D'Angelo Branch. Surprisingly, we haven't called his name nearly as much as we thought we would in this game.
Well, you know, we talked about that at halftime. I think the biggest thing, he's been used as a decoy. There's been numerous times when quarterback Dennis Brown has faked to D'Angelo Branch, pulled the ball out, and then he's taken off running. He had a running touchdown off of that same play action, and he also had a 50-yard touchdown run early in the first quarter. So I think Branch coming into this game is the main target. They've used him as a decoy. Let Dennis Brown do the damage with the running, with his running ability.
That decoy just picked up 5 yards on first down, giving Norfolk State a very workable second and five. Branch in the backfield with Brown. Brown was looking for Dario Walker, just a little wide, wide right.
You know, I take a look at this Norfolk State offense. I think what they will need to do next year in order to become a really good offense in the MEAC, they're going to have to find a receiver that can really stretch the defense. I mean, they have some really good possession receivers in Jamar Johnson and also Dario Walker, but these guys don't have the big play ability that they need. And I think they do a good job of running the ball with Branch and also Dennis Brown. They complete a high percentage of plays. But in college football, you need to be able to score on an 80-yard pass play every now and then.
You have Jeremy Wicker, number 17, who's a redshirt sophomore who will be back. Possibility there.
I'll tell you one thing Pete Adrian does in this situation, he does a great job of going out and get one or two transfers to fill that special
need. Prior to the snap, false start on the offense, number 66, 5-yard penalty, third down.
It's Andy Raymer, the senior from Menifee, California, with a miscue. You were noting that Adrian does a good job of getting recruits, so you anticipate someone hitting the roster next year that we don't even see on the radar now?
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised. Talking to a couple people around at Norfolk State, they kind of have their eyes on one or two people who may be transferring, and he does a good job. He doesn't get a lot of transfers, but in this situation, hey, I need a big play receiver. Let me go find one to fill that need.
Third and 10, Brown under pressure. Eludes it. Completes the pass almost. He was looking to Jamar Johnson, who already has a couple of touchdown passes in the game. Ball a little low, but it still was catchable.
Yeah, and Jamar Johnson, this guy has been around a while, 2 touchdown passes today. He usually will make that catch, and on third down, that's one that you really need. How to help your quarterback out. Dennis Brown getting out of traffic and just doesn't look it in. Like he took his eye off the football at the last minute.
Should have had that one. Billy Rudd back to punt. Brandon Hudson, the primary receiver, number 22. there's a bit of curricular activities going on between a couple of players down at the 35-yard line. Officials separate them. We'll continue play. MEAC on ESPNU after this.
Guaranteed.
Norfolk State leading Delaware State 28-10, 12 minutes remaining in the third quarter. Time to check in with our ESPNU campus connection, Norfolk State senior Joe Cook, mass communications major from Portsmouth, Virginia. Joe, understand there is a little news about the best athletic department in the MEAC?
Yes, NSU has been the winner of four straight Talmadge Lehman Hill Awards. Now, those awards go to the best men's program in the MEAC. NSU's basketball team, baseball team, and football team all had winning records last year. That's the first time that happened at NSU since moving to Division I. Also, 42 student-athletes were made to the MEAC all-academic team, and the graduation rate for student-athletes has increased from 40% to 55%, so the Spartans doing well on and off the field.
Thank you, Joe, and that last number, Eddie Robinson Jr., was probably the most important number that Joe could share with us.
That's pretty impressive because you have to realize that these guys are definitely student-athletes, and the student comes before the athlete, so when you have guys graduating at that percentage rate, that's great for your program and for the kids.
Saw some of the coaching staff and the athletics director doing a great job here at Norfolk State as they help shape young men and women to be productive in our country's future. Eddie Robinson Jr., our entire ESPNU crew, I'm Dwayne Ballin. We are here in Norfolk, Virginia. This is MEAC football between Norfolk State wearing green on senior day and Delaware State wearing gray. Delaware State has actually won this series. The last five games, Al Levan there has won every game in this matchup with Pete Adrian since the two have been going head-to-head. But right now, he is in danger of losing for the first time in this series as his Hornets with the ball trail at 28-10, 11:24 remaining in the third quarter. Sean Winton is all-everything quarterback, has struggled trying to get things going in this series. This may be a free play. And it is. It's tipped and caught. That should be a first down. It was caught by number 11, Darius Jackson, the freshman from Quincy, Florida.
Defense, this penalty is a crime. Results of the play, first down.
So we heard from our referee, Lemon Williams. So that's alert play if you're offense.
Yes, a very good heads-up play by the senior quarterback, Bashawn Winton, realizing that, hey, I have a free play, and you know what, I can force it into triple coverage because if they intercept it, it doesn't count.
And it was actually tipped by number 21, Josh Anderson, the strong safety for Norfolk State. But on that particular play, it just went the way of the Hornets, who are now in Norfolk State territory. Pass and a reception. That's Eric Jones. Defensively there, number 58 for Norfolk State. Hassan Craig.
I tell you what, Bashawn Winton, he has a pretty lively arm. He throws it a little behind the receiver, but throws it out there with a lot of mustard. Good throw and catch, taking what the defense gives you. Now you get into a second and five situation. Maybe you want to take a shot deep or try a big play to try to get back into the ball game.
5-yard pickup for Delaware State. Kareem Jones has a first down on the ground. Still on his feet, breaking into the secondary. May have been a touchdown saving tackle made by number 9, Terrell Whitehead.
I think Kareem Jones is one of those guys. I mean, he's not very big. And I think what he does is just get behind those big offensive linemen, and he just keeps his legs moving. Look at the big guys up front. Once he gets in between there, no one can really see him. And defensively, I tell you what happens. Everyone thinks that the guy is tackled, and you start to ease up a little bit, and all of a sudden you see this lightning bolt just break out of the pile, and hey, it's Kareem Jones.
23-yard pickup for the senior transfer from Syracuse. Ball at the 19-yard line. Jones again, this time trying to break outside. Not as much going there as he is quickly met and stopped. Leading the way defensively was Dante Hodge, number 48, the outside linebacker.
Yeah, Dante Hodge has been playing a pretty good game today. And defensively, you can't run sideline to sideline against this Norfolk State team. They do a very good job of running to the football. They have a good cornerbacks who come up and good run support with free safety Terrell Whitehead, you do better off just trying to run straight at him. I think when Kareem Jones has been having success, it's been mainly between the tackles.
Winton looking up top for LaRon Moore. He could not quite get to it defensively. There was number 43 for Norfolk State, Marcus Cooper Copperwood.
And Marcus Copperwood, only a freshman, covering the speedy LaRon Moore, who had his first touchdown reception last week. He's a track guy, has the speed, but just couldn't track down that pass by Vashawn Witten, just over his head by a couple yards.
So it's third and 12 at the Norfolk State 21-yard line. Delaware State really needs 6 points. Went into the air again. Has a man open. Touchdown, Hornets.
Touchdown,
Darius
State.
Jackson.
Called it Darius Jackson, a freshman, 5'10", 185, gets his first touchdown reception of the year. It keeps Del State in this football game. Like you said, they really needed a score coming out. Starting this third quarter, Vashawn Witten sees the guy open. It's Darius Jackson, number 11. He beats the defender, going right back to the same spot as before.
Riley Flinkinger on for the extra point. It's good. So Delaware State slowly working its way back into this game. Cut the deficit down to 11. 8:55 remaining in the third quarter.
76 has playing on ESPN.com.
Darius Jackson has just scored to pull Delaware State to within 11, 28-17 of Norfolk State. 8:55 remaining in the third quarter. Sunday, ESPNU shoots three college basketball games your way from the O'Reilly Auto Parts CBE Classic. First, at 2:15 Eastern, the Bradley Braves take on the Florida Gators. Then, at 6:30 Eastern, the Lemoyne Dolphins face the city's big boys, Syracuse, who are led by Johnny Flynn. And at 8:30 Eastern, the UMKC Kangaroos meet the defending champion, Kansas Jayhawks. The O'Reilly Auto Parts CBE Classic on ESPNU Sunday. For more information, log on to ESPNU.com. Dolphins and Kangaroos.
Pretty good. I like those. I think what we should have is the Dolphins actually play the Kangaroos. Now that would be a good game.
We need a wallaby in there somewhere. Short kickoff. Norfolk State now will get the ball, come back out on the field, but they cannot afford to be conservative or play as though they're just playing now to get out, because 8:55 remaining in the third quarter, it's an 11-point game.
Yeah, it's too much time in the ball game, like you said, just to say we're going to start running out the clock. I think you still have to come with your plays. I mean, you've been using Dennis Brown as a runner today. He's been doing a very good job. Hey, let him run the football a couple more times and still try to make a big play, maybe to Jamar Johnson.
Pete Adrian, Spartans looking to extend their current win streak to 3. Delaware State's defensive unit was not fooled at all on that running play. Dennis Brown, that time, they were ready for him.
Well, last time we called Dennis Brown's number, of course, he responded with a touchdown for us in the first half. This time, it wasn't so successful. And like you said, Dell State, I mean, they've seen that play a couple times today. He had a 50-yarder off of that play and also scored a touchdown. So they're prepared now, seemingly, for the running plays that Dennis Brown may have.
Pickup of just one on the play sets up 2nd and 9. As you look at 94 Ron Spinner and his teammate 99 Andre Carroll, who really have to bear down and put pressure now on Brown. In and out of the hands of Jeremy Wicker, number 17. Brown wants to know what happened.
Yeah, Wicker was open for a second, running a curl route. Looked like he was curling to the inside, and Dennis Brown threw the ball to the outside. So I think the momentum of the receiver kind of took him away. And you can see Dennis Brown is a little disappointed. He felt like he put one there that should have been caught.
Brown, an outstanding student, by the way, 3.0 GPA. Eddie mentioned earlier his transfer from UConn, came in from day one saying, basically, I am your leader. Let's go get it. Brown This time he connects. Nice pass into traffic. Ball is caught and hauled in for a first down by Daryl Dickerson, a redshirt sophomore receiver from Richmond.
That's a nice throw. I tell you what, he puts this one right in the triple coverage. You can see the safety coming from the inside, and he also beats the corner trailing. There you go. Let me throw the ball a little more, coach. I can throw it.
26-yard pickup, and the Spartans are now into Delaware State territory. Edgman breaks outside, but is knocked for a loss. Alert fly by Avery Grant, number 21, the strong safety coming up to make the tackle for a loss.
Yeah, and Avery Grant, I tell you what, he leads the team with 6.5 tackles for loss. Had a couple tackles behind the line of scrimmage today. This is a strong safety that plays into the opponent's backfield. Very aggressive guy at 5'11", 180 pounds. What you like about him, he's a real good tackler. I don't think I've seen him miss any today.
And that's interesting. You made a point. Usually when you see those numbers for a safety, that means they're getting into the secondary. But he's really making plays in the offensive backfield.
Exactly. He's a guy who plays around the line of scrimmage, sort of like a linebacker, a rover guy, and he's a tough little player.
Brown, time to throw. Into traffic again. This time, it was very nearly picked off.
Say what, we call that a missed opportunity for a big play. That's one he should have had. Now keep in mind that earlier Dell State dropped a touchdown pass. Now you see them not taking advantage of a play that could have easily been intercepted by Jerome Strum, number 29. Would have been a tough catch, just couldn't get both hands under the football, but that's one that you would like to have if you're Dell State. Try to catch it with his feet, look like.
So it's third and 14 for Norfolk State. Spartans probably need to convert here because Delaware State would probably feel that much more confident coming back out offensively.
Look at the blitz.
Brown looking long, has a man open. Excellent closing and coverage by number 23, James Romaine. Because if he doesn't get there, Dario Walker walks into the end zone.
And I thought Romaine was going to have a chance to intercept that pass. You can tell he was clearly beat to the post. They had an all-out blitz, no safety in the middle of the field. But number 23, James Romaine, look at the quick closing speed. It's like a young Willie Mays going up for that catch, just stretching across the receiver.
Was that Vic Wirtz throwing it? Okay, I'm really dating myself. Romaine, the 39 tackles, 3 INTs. So on comes the punter, Billy Rudd, number 38 from Norfolk State. Angling for the corner, it is fielded by Romaine. And he gets away from the would-be tackler, but finally is corralled down by three other players. But he was in and out of the grasp of one defender. So Romaine figuring prominently on the last two plays. Delaware State's offense will get the ball back and see if the Hornets can cut even more into that Spartan lead. MEAC on ESPNU. MEAC football on ESPNU. We're at Norfolk State, Price Stadium, Delaware State taking on Norfolk State. Along with Eddie Robinson Jr., our entire ESPNU crew, I'm Dwayne Ballin, and Joe Cook is our campus connection, a senior mass communications major. We're glad you decided to join us. Has been a very interesting game on this senior day after starting off slowly. Norfolk State really got it going, moved out to a 28-10 halftime lead, but now Delaware State apparently has momentum on its side. College basketball on ESPNU continues Sunday when the Rhode Island Rams take on the Duke Blue Devils. After earning a gold medal in Beijing, Mike Krzyzewski looks to lead the Blue Devils back to glory. For more information, log on to ESPNU.com. College Hoops is back. Delaware State now with the ball, operating from its own 15-yard line. Can Bashan Winton get them even closer? Kareem Jones twisting his way for a couple of yards.
I tell you what, Kareem Jones, he seems like that type of back that will get better as the game goes on. Seems a little nicked up here, but the last series, he had a couple plays where He broke some tackles towards the end of the run, and seems like he was getting stronger and was starting to really move the pile once he got into that Norfolk State defense after the first contact.
Left the field gingerly, has been replaced by number six, Chris Strother. Interesting set for Delaware State. Offensive line doesn't move.
Yeah, they took a play off. I've never seen that before. And they're still standing there. They don't have
very interesting play.
I think they were expecting it to be offside. They thought it would be a neutral zone infraction, but the referee never threw the flag, so they all just stood there.
Okay, all together now.
They're well coached. Coach said don't move, and we're not moving. Sean Witten is on his own.
That's the old daddy. I'm sorry. Mommy said don't open the door for anyone. Third and eight from the 11-yard line for Delaware State. Check that, the 17-yard line. Delaware State is calling a timeout. And this is a really a critical point for Delaware State because the game is still within reach.
Yeah, 28-17. You're down by 11 points. You get a touchdown here, or even if you get a field goal, you can cut it to a one-score game.
Log on to your online source for all things college sports, ESPNU.com. This online service is a gateway to all college sports content from ESPN, combining the latest news with an expanded collection of exclusive material, scores, columns, video and audio highlights, podcasts, live streaming games, and much more. Log on to ESPNU.com today. And now, ESPNU is available in high definition. To get the great action on ESPNU in high definition, contact your local cable operator or satellite provider. ESPNU HD, the big picture in college sports. So Eddie Robinson Jr., what is the big picture here right now? Norfolk State, you have an 11-point lead. Delaware State, you're still trying to figure out and stay in it.
Well, I think, first of all, if you're Dell State, you have a big third down conversion, and you're going against a team that's ninth in the conference in third down efficiency from a defensive standpoint. If you can convert here, get a new set of downs, and just run your offense. You're not in panic mode if you're Dell State. You still have run-pass options. You get one score, and you are right back in the football game.
Rashawn Winton is just a tight man that can lead them. Senior quarterback, such a threat with his legs. He's made some plays with his arm today. Going to the air. It is in and out of the hands of Strother, but it finds the waiting hands of LaRon Moore, number three. So that's one way to complete a pass.
Yeah, that's an interesting way. I mean, I don't know who the ball was intended for. Of course, if you're Rashawn Winton, you say, I was throwing that ball to LaRon Moore all the time. It actually confused the defender because he was trying to tackle number six, Chris Strother, and once it went over his head, it was the first down completion. But, of course, we have a flag down, so we'll have to wait on the referee's call.
From a dead ball, personal foul against the defense, number one. Unnecessary roughness, 15 yards from the end of the run. The foul also requires an automatic first down.
That's a surprise because Dennis Marsh is one of the leaders on this team. And he usually leads with his head.
Yeah, he's one of those guys that in this senior class, of course, his senior day, that's not the type of thing you want to have. And see, he's telling coaches, my fault. You know, I lost control. But you like a kid like that. Come to the sideline, don't make any excuses. Tell Coach Adrian you made a mistake, and you go out there and play hard from the next series.
On the very rare and very far between times that might have happened with you, did your coach respond? Did it work? Did it get you out of the doghouse?
It didn't happen too much, but one time it did happen. And
Strother, very little.
And all you can do is just go to the side. I tell you what, when it was. You know, I played with Jacksonville for a couple years, and then when I went to the Tennessee Titans, I caught an interception. I actually slammed the ball, and it hit Coach Coughlin, who was then the head coach of the Jaguars. So it was a great interception, but then it was a bonehead play for me, slamming the ball and hitting him with the ball, which was an accident, I must say, but still got a 15-yard penalty and a fine.
But did it work? Did you get out of the doghouse after you took
Coach Fisher wasn't very
responsibility.
Happy. He wasn't very happy. I took responsibility, but no, it didn't work.
Okay, so Dennis Marsh is still in trouble.
Yeah.
Second and eight for Delaware State, trailing by 11. Strother on the delay.
gets out over the 45-yard line, where he's greeted.
I tell you what, but football is one of those emotional sports, and sometimes things just happen on the football field. And I think that's what with Dennis Marsh, that's exactly what happened with him. Now he's, you know, he's back out there, and if you're a coach, you have a senior guy, you say, hey, big fella, you made a mistake. You know, we all realize it. Go out there, and now you need to make a play for me. You owe me one. And that's what a player can respect. You know, coaches have to realize that sometimes players, you know, we make those type of mistakes. Just want to go out there and get another chance to make your coach proud.
Started his collegiate career at Maryland. Found a home at Norfolk State. That five-yard run sets up third and four. Third down conversions for Delaware State, just 4 of 9. Strother still in the backfield. He came in to replace Kareem Jones, who limped off a number of plays back in this series. It's Strother. That's a first down and more. Into the secondary. Tackled by Terrell Whitehead. But boy, did the redshirt senior from Miami take off and pick up yardage on that play. A gain of 15 on the run.
Yeah, just right up the middle. Good job by the guys up front. Chris Sears, number 71, with the block moving the pile. And then you see Chris Strother just going through there to get that first down. And I tell you what, this is a very dangerous part of the football game if you're Norfolk State, because the momentum has definitely switched to the other sideline. And if they can convert and finish this drive off with a touchdown, man, you're going to have a head. You have a real great ending for Norfolk.
Ball at the 29-yard line of Norfolk State. That's Strother again, and he is becoming difficult to bring down. Once again, Whitehead, number 5, the first man to get to him.
I can tell you the referees, they're going to have those yellow handkerchiefs on the ground quite a bit, because these guys are kind of testy after every play. And I like what he does right here. Look how he just hides behind those big offensive linemen. Chris Sears, number 71, 68. Nick Richmond, and no one can see him. I mean, this guy is 5'10 and 185 pounds, and once he disappears, the defenders can't keep an eye on him, and all of a sudden he comes out of nowhere and just takes off.
Second and 5 for Delaware State. Strother again. Carries a couple of green jerseys with him, the most prominent of which belong to number 31, Anthony Taylor.
Coach Al Levan is relying heavily on the running game last week against Winston-Salem State. You remember Kareem Jones had 35 rushes on his own for 230 yards. He was a little nicked up on the series before, so now you put in redshirt senior Chris Strother, same type of running back, same size and stature. And he's continuing where Kareem Jones left off from last week. And from an offensive lineman standpoint, they all love to run block, especially in a game like this. It's muddy, kind of rainy and wet. Just let us run a block, coach, and just pound this defense.
Third and 2. Whistles on the field, and markers are down.
Delay of game on the offense, number 2, 5-yard penalty, third down.
Could not get the playoff in time.
Yeah, that's a big mistake by Dell State, because I feel like they had something working on that play, plus it was 3rd and 2. Look at Chris Strother right here, 3 straight carries, 25 yards. I tell you what, on that last 3rd and 2 play, if I'm a coach, it's hard for me not just to hand it off to number 6 again and see what happens.
But now, you just pointed out, this is not only a dangerous part of the game for Norfolk State, but an essential part for Delaware State to stay in it. So you almost have to go to the air here, don't you?
Well, I would think so. I mean, or you can get the quarterback in the run pass option. But I think it's 2-down territory. If you don't get it on 3rd down, I think you go for it on 4th down if you're the Hornets.
You're right. Winton can be so dangerous when he rolls out with his on 2 legs. So he's going to stay in the pocket, drops it off to Strother out of the backfield. And he is taken out of bounds by number 18, Jamie Short. That's a 1st down, and Delaware State continues to move the ball. This man, Chris Strother, has been key in this drive.
Yeah, you're talking about a guy coming into the game. He has 14 receptions, so he's very good in the passing game. And watch this move here, how you just hesitate and make a miss. Able to get those couple extra yards to get close enough for that 1st down. I think they're going to measure it to see just how close he is. But I think if you're Dell State, it doesn't matter. Whether you get it or not, you're still going for it on fourth down.
Delaware State coming into this game has lost three straight, 3-3 in the conference, 3-6 overall. Last week, a disappointing loss to Winston-Salem State at home, 27-26. And that was senior day for them.
You know, in Winston-Salem State, you know, Dell State felt like they should have beaten, but the week before, Hampton felt like they should have beat Winston-Salem State. So maybe Coach Blunt has a pretty good team down there.
It's got to be difficult in the conference when the team isn't qualified to play for the championship, but yet you play them.
Right.
And you lose.
Well, the good thing is it doesn't count.
Yeah, but you still lose.
You still lose. And that's all that matters at the end of the day is, you know, coaches all over America, from Pee Wee to the pros, you're judged on wins and losses.
And that certainly suggests that Winston-Salem State is sounding the clarion before it gets into competition that we are to be reckoned with.
Right, because they're still in the transition phase. So, I mean, they don't have the full allotment of players. Of course, they're moving from Division II up to the FCS level, so they're going to be a pretty competitive team, well coached also.
So it's first down for Vashawn Winton and his Delaware State Hornets teammates facing an 11-point deficit. They were down 28-10 at the half. Ball at the 20-yard line of Norfolk State, senior day for the Spartans. This time it's Winton calling his own number around the left side, and he finally goes down. Terrell Whitehead, number 9, there defensively for Norfolk State.
You know, one thing I do like about Al Levan and the play calling that he has right now, he's not in a panic mode. I mean, he realizes that we're two scores down, but we still have a whole nother quarter to play. So let's still have the running game, still have some passes and play action. You know, some coaches get in this situation and feel like we have to score on the next play. And that's not the case. You can still run your offense. You have time to get two scores on the board if you're Dell State.
5-yard pickup sets up 2nd and 5. Strother up the middle. Whitehead greets him head on.
Tell you what, Terrell Whitehead says, I'm the bully of this block. I mean, he ran in there hard. He tried to move the pile, but number 9, Terrell Whitehead, would have nothing of it. Of course, he leads this team in tackles from the strong safety position. And that's how you stand the little guy up. You get under his pads and you still knock him back. Preseason MEAC Defensive Player of the Year there, Terrell Whitehead, number 9. What a player.
That will end the third quarter here in Norfolk, Virginia. Clouds are settling back over Price Stadium. 28-17, Norfolk State leading on senior day. When we return, we'll discuss coaching situation in college football and some coaches that we think deserve a shot at the major level. MEAC on ESPNU.
Coaster today.